Good evening, guys. It's Sunday, the 5th of March, and it's almost 9:45. This is my Windows XP gaming rig. And I've got to there's a reason why it's up here on the desk. Because I'm going to recase it all. So, because I haven't got a lot of room up here, I need to take this one apart first. I'm just thinking for a second. Just bear with me 1 second. Well, a few more than 1 second, but you know what I mean. I totally forgot to get this before I turned the camera on, but never mind. I want this. There's a reason for this. Reason so much that I actually might have to just turn that PC around. No, I can't turn that thing around, can I? Power cable, even though I'm taking it apart, but there is a reason for that. And I've got my boots on as well. I don't have an anti-static wrist strap. So what I've done, plug this in, because this will earth this. And because this is connected to the case, it's going to earth that as well. So when I go like that, it will discharge me. So here we go. Take the side cover off. Trying to keep out of the way as much as possible. Okay. I have got my pot of screws on here, haven't I? Yeah. Right, let me take that off. Because as you can see, there's no room to put any extra hard drives in. And as I want to play some older sort of Windows XP era games, I need more storage. So, I could put a SATA. Can I put a SATA on this one? Yes, because the DVD drive is a thingamajig. IDE. Swear I forget my head sometimes if it weren't permanently attached. I'm going to take this little cover off next. Just drop you down a little bit. That's better. You don't really need to see my ugly mug and do all this, do you? You're more interested in what I'm doing rather than... Get off of there, you bastard. There we go. Right. Is there a little tab that is, but I can't get it. There we go. And I want that out as well, don't I? Right. That's the video card that is being used. It's an ATI Radeon 1800 XT. That actually came with the Windows 7 computer when I bought it. Although the drivers didn't work as they should have done. What a funny feeling. I may need to take that panel off as well. Once I get the more sensitive items out, like the motherboard and whatnot, and unplug the power cable. Pardon me. Right, so, next task. We'll take that out. We'll take the fan off, out of the way. Come on, you bastard. And I need fan screws for when I attach fans to the other one, because I've got some light-up ones I'm going to fit. Forewarning, this might be a long video. But that'll be a long video of me actually doing something. Instead of just randomly talking to the camera and wandering aimlessly around the flat like a lost sheep. Right, I don't want that one. Good brand though, Cooler Master. But I'm not putting that in the new case. Great. Unplug that, unplug that, unplug that, unplug. Oh, there's four SATA ports. Unplug that one. I think this is going to be easier if I lay it down now. Well, as it's Sunday, those that have followed me, I don't know why you'd follow me, but those that have followed me for a while will know Sundays is when I go over to Mum's for roast dinner and what have you. She's not very sociable though, you know. About 10 minutes after I get there, she's buggered off into the lounge and gone to sleep in the armchair. And my stepdad had gone out to the workshop. And I'm just sort of sitting there thinking, oh, well, sod the lot of you then. Why I'm taking this power supply out, I don't know, but never mind. I've started now, so I'll finish. An old line from the Krypton Factor. That's showing my age a little bit as well, isn't it? Krypton Factor! Didn't really watch that show. Just got glimpses of it now and again, you know. Right. Oh, I'm glad the screwdriver's magnetic. So I'll take my laptop over to Mum's though, because that gives me something to do. I don't know what it means on this motherboard, but two of the SATA ports are red and two are black. I don't know, is that two different speeds, or did Asus just think, you know, they'll use two different colours because they could? Who knows? But I could, if I wanted to, which I might do just because I can, we'll see. I could put an SATA disk drive in here. Okay, I'm just seeing what other headers we've got. We've got two USB headers. I just want to check that. Probably fit an extra card reader in, because this is the CD drive that's got the card reader. Of course, if I change that for an SATA one, which basically just means it'll read discs a bit quicker. You know, like I said, I've got the SATA drives, I might as well fit the damn things, so don't think the case my brother gave me actually has it. Right. Now. I'm nuts. I should have pulled the power plug first. Okay. Right, so in theory, this should pop straight out of there. And I'm going to lay that on here. Pop the IO shield out because I'll need that. Okay, I'm going to unplug that. I think that's a fan adapter, is it? No, that's the adapter for the video card, which I'm not going to change. Not yet, anyway. What's this one? That's for the front fan. I wired that on there, didn't I? Don't think I'll need that for the front fans, but just in case, I'll take that off and I'll wire up the new fans. Don't think I'll need a floppy drive. It's a hard drive screw, there the motherboard screws, there are all the other screws, anyway. Yeah. Just as I suspected. Screwed in on both sides. It is a 500 watt power supply. I have to say, I wasn't expecting that. And whose bright fucking idea was to stick the cable around there? Cable management can be so annoying at times. Anyway, there we go, that's that area. So, turn that back up. Off. I am keeping this case though because if I ever find any more AGP type video cards, I have no means to test them at the minute. So I'm going to just build a simple Windows XP machine that I could just use, you know, as a test rig, I suppose. Asus built this well, 4 screws on the hard drive. I'm actually tempted to take the fan off the front just because I'd want the screws for the fans on the other case. Right, so there's the main drive, which is an 80 gigabyte drive. So like I said, I'm just going to pop the front cover off. Actually, that's a black floppy disk drive. I'll take that out of there in case I do decide to stick one on the other case. So I can't remember if there's a hole there or not. I'm going to leave that in here. Because if I want a card reader on the other one, I'll use a... separate one. So yeah, maybe tomorrow, or in the next video, whenever I decide to do the next video, I'll build this one in, or just a little simple XP machine. I've got that 8 gigabyte hard drive that I got out of the computer stuff that I could slap in here. Get out of there, you bugger. Another dinky little light-up fan. Right, I can take this down now and just stick it over here. Well, I can hear it, but I can't see it. So there's a few bits and bobs I need to go get, so I'm just going to get organised again. But while I do that, so you're not sitting here looking at nothing, I'll just turn you off and I'll be back in, I don't know, well, as quick as I click my fingers. And just like that, the new case. Which I've forgotten to get the other panel off of. Forgot to get the other panel off. And yes, the front panel is off for a reason as well. Alright. So, I've been and got a few bits and pieces. Okay, so I won't be fitting a floppy drive to this. No, I won't. So that can go to one side. I've got all the hard drives and everything. So I'm going to start with our 500 watt power supply. Are we on camera? We are on camera. Okay. Might be these four screws. Yeah, I almost come through unprepared again. Because I'd forgotten that I needed the case fans and a couple of other things. Does my gut look big on here? I can't help, that's just one of the things I notice. If I notice it, everyone else probably notices it. But you know what? I don't give a fuck. And one more up top. I like to put the power supply in first on these types of cases, because the motherboard is underneath and I don't want to damage anything on the motherboard by, you know, fiddling around trying to get the bleeding power supply in. So in cases where the power supply goes at the top, I always start with that. Right. Yeah. If I really, really, really wanted to, I could replace the broken reset switch. I can't remember what I took the end off for now. I took it off for something, but I can't remember what. So, well, it's not needed, so I'm just going to cut that cable back out of the way. When I can remember, oh here we go, just use a pair of scissors, that'll do. That's because I can't be bothered to go through and, who uses a bloody reset switch anyway? You don't need them anymore. There we go, I'll just disconnect it. Go away. At least I hope that's the reset switch. I'm screwed if that's not. Right. I can lay that down. I can knock the scissors on the floor. That's the front panel for the other case. So now, I've got to pop in our IO shield. Good, we are on camera. Got offered a nice job lot of Lego for 130 quid, and it includes a fair bit of railway stuff. So I've been trying to rake the cash together for it. Got no one who can learn what I need, and by that I mean I've got 80 quid so far. Well, I've got a bit more than that, but some of it I've got to use for posting, to pay for postage. So what I've actually got is 80 quid, so I need 50 smackers. But my stepdad has said, because I've got till Friday, that offered it to me is alright to keep it all till Friday for me, so I might just have to take this board out again because I've got a standoff in the wrong place. I do hate that. Even more so because you don't usually notice till you put the bloody board in. Right. And I'm just going to check that these screws I've got will fit them all. So I've got one down here that they won't. Right, I'm going that one. I think that's an odd one. It is an odd one. Bloody would be, wouldn't it? Yeah, it goes in all the others fine, so I've got to remember that I'm going to have to find a different screw for just that one. Motherboard looks bloody tiny in this case. So yeah, my stepdad did say, you know, he'll loan me whatever I need later in the week. When he gets paid, so yay. Like I said, it's quite a large lot of Lego. There's two huge container fulls, a few loose bits and pieces, including a train and a controller, and a box full of railway bits. I suppose there's three boxes then, two big plastic tubs and a box. So someone should be collecting a bike tomorrow, so that's another 25 quid to the kitty. Yeah, I've got 27 quid in my PayPal, but I've got to take out for at least two packages. To be posted, that is. Not a biggie. Mind you, though, it's, even if I take out for the two packages, that's still, let me just think. Still gives me an extra tenner there, so that's going to be 115 quid in the kitty, which means I would only have to find 15 quid. I'm sure I could find something. I've got a bunch of stuff already loaded into my trailer to go to Black Records, and well, to him it's got to be worth at least 20 quid, so I could probably get there all the cash together myself, to be honest. It's just, it is nice to know that, you know, my stepdad will step in if I need it. But I think I could actually get everything on my little trailer as well. I didn't think I could at first, but I think I can. I'll just have to stack it and then strap it down as best I can. And hope it doesn't fly everywhere. Otherwise that will be one heck of a mess to clean up on the road. So yeah, I am really, really looking forward to getting it. When it comes to things I want like that, that's when I can be a bit impatient, because you know, I want the money now and I want to go get it now. I don't want to keep waiting, but unfortunately it doesn't work like that, does it? Well, I presume one of these is USB and one of these is card reader. Yeah, the black one's card reader, right. Well, I'm not going to put anything like that on yet. I need to stand it up. Now that I've got the two tricky bits in, I'm going to stand up. Yeah, this has got sort of like a built-in card reader on the front of this. It's really weird. Fan on the front here that I'm going to take off. I'm going to put an illuminated one on the front. I was going to put an illuminated one on the back, but it can't really be seen at the back, so I don't know if I really need to bother. can't remember what make this one is. Is that cooler? No, it isn't, but I may put this black one on the back. Because, well, when it's going to be either under the new desk when I build that or under there, the back one's not going to be seen anyway, is it? So, wiggle that one out of there. And the only reason I'm doing that, besides that one's the noisy one. I don't want the noisy one. I want this one. Get this plonked in. Doing the fan now so I can actually get the front clipped back on. That just makes moving the case around a little easier. If I can line up the friggin' screw holes. I've got four screws, I might as well stick at least another one in. Make sure I've got that around in the case, of course. Okay. Solid screw doesn't want to go in. So I can't be arsed. That'll do. Just get this clip back on, I think. So, and put these back on. It's got room on this case for four CD drives. Yeah, no idea why four. Speaking of Pioneer or LG, I'm gonna go with Pioneer, I think. Screw holes all lined up, good. A couple of fan screws. Get that screwed in, there we go. I'll just turn the case so you can actually see. Right. Not got a lot planned for tomorrow. Mum might be coming uptown. I've got to go across to QD's and hope they've got their cardboard bins out so I can get some cardboard for this bloody computer here. I won't do the other side yet because otherwise I'd have to keep switching it round. That's found a 320 gigabyte SATA drive or another 80 gig. And I thought I'm making this pretty damn good. I might as well go all out and use a 320. I've also got a 500 in there, but I'd rather keep that because I've got another use for that. So I don't really want to use it in this one. Two of these in this side. I will put screws in the other side, but as I've got to turn it around to put screws on the other side, I thought I might as well just do all of these first. See what I mean? If you're wondering why I didn't put that directly under that one, it's for airflow. Don't want them too close together. You can. It probably wouldn't matter that much because I've got the fan on the front, but I personally don't. These are going to be the only two hard drives I stick in here, so, well, I don't think I'm going to need any others. Right. You know what? So far this recasing is going well. Not one, you know, little technical glitch. I've got two screws in the other side, so I'm only going to stick one in each one here. I'm pretty certain I don't need to stick two in. I could, because I've got shitloads of friggin' screws. I've got more than this as well somewhere. This is just sort of like half of it. You just love it when you drop screws like that. Should we try that again? There we go. We're nearly there, chaps. We are nearly there. Apart from fitting a fan at the rear, which I was just going to fit that black one, wasn't I? Because I've got that one. I've got the power cables. I've got the power cables already plugged into the motherboard. So, this one's going to go on the rear. I've got a Diddy fan that might just stick on the side panel for shits and giggles. That lights up as well. Speaking of lighting up, my brother's put blue lights underneath his desk. Which I have to say, looks pretty damn bloody good. He only got them because where my stepdad gets his LED lights from for his scrubbers, algae scrubbers, sent him the wrong ones. So instead of sending them back, he gave them to my brother. Third one in here. This case is quite a flexible case for some reason. I'm going to go through and possibly put some blanks on there if I can find them. If not, I'm not going to worry about it. Right. That's the rear chassis fan. That can go on the actual board. He says, he doesn't want to plug in. There we go. Right. I don't really want that cable flailing around there. Is there anything I can do with that? Not really. Bastard. For the minute. Okay, so we've got to connect everything up now. This is gonna be fun. Right. Is that audio? Because I'm gonna do that first, because that's usually a pig. There's a lot of room in this case. That's why I like this case so much. It's not the best looking case, but there's just so much room. Trying to see which USB was which. That's got to go on there. And that one on there. And it's got the switch cables. For some obscure reason, we'll taped together. Right, I know power switch goes there. Doobly doobly two. Oh. LED don't work, then I know I've got the wires around the wrong way. And the last one, because I've not put the reset switch on. I was going to say, we're done. No, we're not. So I've got these. Right, so two red. Red to red. Ooh. Ah! Plus, a bit of a bummer. I've got three SATA devices and only two power connectors, but that does not matter. Simply because I've got adapters in the kitchen. I'll grab one quickly in a minute. I'll just get all this plugged in. So that's the two power cables. I've got a Molex to SATA adapter. I'll just have to use that, that's all. But I think I'm nearly ready to go power it up. So that goes in there, and I want one more. I'll use me blue, I think. I'll just quickly run to the box in the kitchen and grab that other one. And grab that Molex adapter. Here we go. I think the only other Molex I need is for this phone. Well, apart from the one that's got to go on the side cover, but I actually now think I'm going to put the side cover back on the other side. That's the wrong one. That's the one I want. Yeah, ooh. Fan connector there. Yeah, I don't think I need that, but yeah, I'll put that on the side panel in a minute. That was just an extra thingy we brought through. Alright, let me get this side on first. I'll get reorganized and set this back up where it's meant to be, and I'll turn you off for that, and I'll turn you back on and we'll see if I've had any success or not, or completely fucked it up. Oh. You could have told me I've forgotten the video card. Guess what I've got to do? I've got to move the hard drive. Bitch. To do that, that means I've got to take the side panel off again. I'll do, because I've now got to piss around and lower these two hard drives down one bay, I'll do that, I'll get the video card in and I'll get it set up over there and I'll switch it back on. Okay, we're set up. There's the computer. I've got to come around the other side of the bloody tripod. Will it work? That sounds great, doesn't it? I've got a wire on a fan somewhere. But I have to sort that out. Sounds like on the front fan. So let's just open her up quickly and have a look. And would you know, I've got fucking screws stuck in there. Don't worry, I know why the screen's not on, it's because the cable's fallen out. Just looking for the bloody screw. Right. Screwed in, hit F1, we'll try this again, shall we? Something's clipping on that front fan and I'm not sure what it is. But we're booting, and I've worked up sweat. Oh dear. Ooh. We have success. And it looks like both indicator LEDs are working as well. What about this? Yep. Good. Right, I can call that a success. There we go. That's today's video. He says, sweating his tits off. So, thanks for watching. If you like the video, give me a thumbs up. Much appreciated. And subscribe if you'd like to, and I will talk to you again in the next video. Ta-ta for now.